Welcome back to a brand new episode of Drawing Shenanigans, my friends. In this episode, I'm going to be doing a challenge, more specifically a Pokemon Fusion challenge. I'm going to be combining the Kanto starters and the Galar starters and create a new, brand new Pokemon, which hopefully you'd like to play as. And this is without a doubt influenced by the fact that I've been playing Pokemon Sword and Shield recently. So without further ado, let's get started. I'm going to begin with Bulbasaur and Grookey, so I'm going to do the normal order in which they're introduced. So you're going to have grass, fire and water, and we're going to start with Grookey and Bulbasaur. As I said, I'm going to give the Pokemon probably a face shape that resembles Grookey's face shape a little bit more. And the idea for this video came from the fact that I thought it would be entertaining to end the year on a positive note and do this challenge. The idea is to incorporate elements from both Pokemon so that when you look at this fusion, you can clearly identify both Pokemon, and hopefully it will be something that looks cute and that people will want to play as. So I certainly want to keep the two leaves that Grookey has on top of its head. That's a very identifiable feature of Grookey, and I like it a lot. And with the face shape, as I was saying, I'm going to give it a Grookey face shape, but I do think I want the eyes to be Bulbasaur eyes, so that there's still elements of Bulbasaur in the face. The ears, as you can see, they're clearly Bulbasaur ears. You will see a lot of edits. I'll probably actually cut out a lot of them, because otherwise these videos would be very, very long. But yeah, the face is certainly more Grookey-like, but with the eyes, there will be Bulbasaur in there as well. But as I was saying, this series, Drawing Shenanigans, despite the fact that in this episode I'm doing something that I just wanted to draw, period, because I thought it would be fun, I do rely on viewer suggestions, so please give me your drawing suggestions for future episodes. I will need them coming into the new year, for sure. And it's something that allows me to interact with all of you. I can't pick all of them because I am just one person doing these projects, and not to mention that I have all my other projects as well. But coming into the new year, these drawing videos, it's something that I really want to do more frequently as well. I know I just got started, in fact this is only episode 5, but with 2020 I really hope that I can do it more frequently. And that's why suggestions are so important, because sometimes it's a little bit hard to find a subject for each video, but in this case I was pretty much determined to do this. I know that Pokemon fusions are pretty popular. I don't think there's a fusion between the Generation 1 starters and this current generation Pokemon starters, but if there is, you know, who knows. But I wanted to throw my idea into the mix. So as you can see, this Pokemon, it has clearly a Grookey face, so we're going to give it more of a Bulbasaur body to compensate a little bit. And then with the body, we'll also include some features from Grookey, so that there's a mix. Right now, it's more like a Grookey with Bulbasaur's eyes and ears. But with the body, it's going to be a Bulbasaur body, like I said. And I have to admit that I like Grookey a lot, and I do like Bulbasaur a lot as well. Unfortunately, when I was a very young child and I played my very first Pokemon game, which, by the way, I have a... Aside from Pokemon Sword and Shield, which I just got like a couple of weeks ago, I hadn't played a single Pokemon game since the very first generation on the Game Boy. My last Pokemon game was Pokemon Yellow, so it's been a long, long time. And I admit that my starter was always Charmander. As a child, I just thought Charmander was the cooler of the three. And I didn't use Bulbasaur a whole lot, but now that I'm older, not necessarily wiser but older, I certainly have a newfound appreciation for Bulbasaur. I think Bulbasaur is extremely cute. It's a shame because I feel it it's the Pokemon that's left behind the most in the first generation, and I think Bulbasaur deserves a chance as well. So if I replayed my old Game Boy, which I suppose I still have somewhere back in my old house in Portugal, but if I replayed the game, I would certainly pick Bulbasaur and give Bulbasaur a chance, because I feel that out of the three starters, I went with Charmander the most, and then I probably picked Squirtle quite a little bit too, and I didn't give Bulbasaur as big of a chance. But with this body, it clearly looks like a Grookey with Bulbasaur's body, which I guess is the point of the fusion, but I want to do something different here, and I want to include the vines, and I thought it might be a good idea to have this Pokemon fusion, which I guess it would be called Bulbaki or Grookasaur. It would be holding the stick that Grookey carries in its hand, and I love that Grookey carries a stick with him or her. I think it's adorable. Instead, this Pokemon would use the vines to hold the sticks up, and it would be the special ability of this Pokemon to use the vines to strike at its enemies with a stick with incredible force, like a whip movement. So it would be a combination of Bulbasaur's vine whip with Grookey's stick throw. Grookey does strike with his stick, but so it would be a more powerful version of that move, which I think would actually make this Pokemon pretty powerful. And we're going to add a second stick. I am liking quite a lot how this Pokemon's looking. I think it's adorable. And to be fair, all the starters, they're cute in their own way. And then we make them battle. But, you know, regardless, it's still nice to see just how cute and adorable they are. Especially in Pokemon Sword and Shield, when you can set up camp and play with your Pokemon and stuff. I love that. I think it's a very neat new feature. We are going to give this Pokemon Grookey's tail, so that there's another element of Grookey there. And looking at the Pokemon right now, it's a pretty nice fusion between both of them. I do, when I do the coloring, I am going to add some more elements of Grookey to the bottom part of the body, especially the paws. That's why I'm adding these lines that you see there on the screen, on the paws. That's just for me to keep in mind that I'm going to color them later. And use Grookey's colors for reference that way. I won't show myself doing the line art or the coloring process, because that would just make this video very, very long. But if that's something that you're interested in, if you would like me to show more of the coloring process and of the line art and so on, let me know, and I would be happy to make videos about it as well. Of course, with this Pokemon, I had already created a few sketches, so I had some idea of what I was doing coming into it. So that's why I'm able to get this drawing out faster. I'm still going to do some retouches and so on. So this Pokemon would be Bulbaki, and then it would either be Grookasaur or Grookasaur. And yeah, I would definitely pick this Pokemon if I had the chance. I like it a lot. It's a very nice fusion, but you should be seeing the finished version now on the screen. There it is, and here it is. I present to you Bulbaki and Grookasaur. So we're going to jump to the next Pokemon, and this is our Fire starter. So this will be a fusion between Charmander and Scorbunny. Both in their own right are very popular Pokemon. As I was saying, back when I was 10 years old, Charmander was usually my starter in every single game, and I played a lot of Pokemon Red and Pokemon Blue. I had both versions, and then I got Pokemon Yellow, and Pokemon Yellow was actually pretty cool because you got to get all three starters and have them all in your team, and I always enjoyed that. Normally I would have a team composed of both Charizard, Venusaur and Blastoise in Pokemon Yellow. And with this Pokemon, we're going to keep elements. It's going to look more like a bunny, but it's going to be kind of as if Charmander became a bunny in a way, because I want the face shape to be more like Charmander, and then we'll incorporate elements of Scorbunny in there as well. But as I was saying, Scorbunny is incredibly popular. To be fair, most fire starters, I feel, on each generation, they're all very popular for the most part. I think a lot of people pick them, and that's totally fine because they look cool, and you know, that just is how it is. And Scorbunny is very energetic, and I can totally understand why people pick Scorbunny. I like Scorbunny a lot. He was not my starter for Pokemon Sword and Shield. I went with a completely different route, but that's because I just like to give other Pokemon a chance as well. And as you can see, this Pokemon, not only does it have the big bunny tooth, it also has Charmander's fangs, so without a doubt, one of these Pokemon's skills would be the Bite ability, and it would deal extra damage because you're getting beaten by a lot of teeth, essentially. With the face shape, as you can see here, it's clearly more of a Charmander face shape, but it's Charmander with Scorbunny's ear, so we're gonna add that for sure. That's a very identifiable feature of Scorbunny. So we want to include that. Let me add these lines here. Like I was saying, initially when I was coming up with these concepts, I actually thought about, well, how about instead of going with a Scorbunny body, give it more of a Charmander body? But I really thought it looked better to use Scorbunny's body kind of as a template and then take it from there. This Pokemon just waving at you, it wants to play with you for sure. And with its legs, we're going to give this Pokemon a soccer ball or a football. Depending on where you live, you'll call it something different. I come from Europe, so we call it football, but I guess now that I live in the United States, I should call it soccer maybe. Either way, this Pokemon fusion, it would have a ball with him or her, and it would be one of its abilities. It would be able to fire essentially like a fireball at you by kicking it. And people would think, look at this creature and they'd be like, oh, it's so adorable, he wants to play a game with me, I'm so happy. And then all of a sudden this bunny would just throw a fireball at you, kick it at you, and you would be burned alive essentially. So maybe not as friendly. To be fair, if there's ever a Pokemon uprising, and it's only fair that they decide to do that, I guess, I think people would be pretty much screwed. I don't think humans would stand a chance. I mean, they've given these Pokemon some insane abilities. I think that we'd be in serious trouble. I am debating if I'm going to give these Pokemon claws like Charmander has or not, but I, for now, let's keep it like this, and then I can always change that when I'm doing the line art. But we're going to give it Charmander's flames on the tail, and essentially it would be something that this Pokemon would use to run faster. So every time the Pokemon wanted to move faster, it would have this ability maybe called Blaze Tail or something, where the flames on its tail would flare up and it would be able to move across the field a lot faster and deliver a powerful kick to its enemies. So that's a special ability that this Pokemon would have as well. And looking at our friend here, I'm actually thinking if we might not have created, instead of a Pokemon fusion, maybe it's supposed to be a cereal mascot. I could totally see this bunny being in the cover of a cereal box and to encourage people to buy the brand new Firecracker cereal. That would totally be the name of the cereal brand. Hopefully there's not such a thing already. But our friend here, he would be called Scormander or Charbunny. Very energetic Pokemon. Maybe this is something that they could do, like create fusions between Pokemon and use them. I mean, they used so many gimmicks in the game, why not do this as well? But here's the finished version. You're going to be seeing it on the screen now. And it looks very happy. And I'm glad this Pokemon wants to play a lot. Very energetic. And now, ladies and gentlemen, for our last starter Pokemon fusion, we're going to have a fusion between Sobble and Squirtle. And I have a confession to make. Heading into the game, when I first bought it just a few weeks ago, not even a few weeks ago, like literally last week, I thought that I was going to go with Grookey. I was determined to have Grookey as my starter, but then Sobble started crying in the opening intro, and I'm a bleeding heart, I couldn't handle it. And I'm like, guess what, buddy, you're coming with me. I just couldn't leave Sobble behind. I felt really bad. Yes, I'm going to be using Sobble to fight, but I still think that, fortunately in this game, none of the Pokemon starters are left by themselves. It's not like in the first generation, and in actually all generations, I think, where they would just be kind of abandoned. Everyone in this game gets picked, and that personally makes me happy, because I wouldn't want a single one of them to be left behind. But yeah, when Sobble first appeared, I just couldn't pick anyone else. I really couldn't. I wanted to give Sobble a chance, especially because I feel that Sobble might have been out of the three starters the Pokemon that got the least amount of attention, and as such, I just wanted to play as Sobble. In fact, in this house, we've been playing as Sobble, and it's just been it's been very fun to just play with Sobble in the camp and see Sobble smile every once in a while. So right now, if you look at this Pokemon, it kind of looks like Squirtle, but a happy Squirtle wearing a little bit of makeup. Obviously, we're going to change that so that Sobble's features are more identifiable as well. I'm going to give it big eyes, because I want this fusion to be smiling and happy, because Sobble looks so serious most of the time. Although when Sobble does smile, and this happens if you play with Sobble, and once Sobble starts warming up to you in the game, it's very endearing. I like it a lot. I'm not very far into the game yet. For reference, I've only just gotten the Water Gym badge, so I'm very early on into the game, but my Sobble has evolved already. I finally allowed Sobble to evolve. I actually wanted Sobble to stay in its base form forever, and its evolution is very different than the initial Pokemon. It gets a bit more moody, but deep down I know that Sobble's still in there, so yeah, I just really like having Sobble in my party. So right now it's like we have a happy Squirtle with Sobble-esque features, but we're going to add Sobble's fin, and now we have a happy Sobble, I think. This Pokemon, I want it to just be a very playful Pokemon, a Pokemon that just, you know, really enjoys hanging out with you. We're going to give it Sobble's hands, because why not? And we'll probably give the Pokemon Squirtle's legs, that way there's a bit of both. It's funny because I feel that with Squirtle, he's kind of the opposite of Sobble in a lot of ways. Squirtle, I feel, is very playful, and for the most part, Squirtle is always happy. So hopefully those qualities would pass a little bit onto Sobble, and Sobble wouldn't cry as much. Not that there's anything wrong with crying, sometimes you just have to do it, but I want Sobble to be happy. And it's interesting because one of the features that I saw with Sobble, in the description it says that when Sobble cries, it's the equivalent of like 100 onions being peeled, and that's just insane, right? That's just absolutely insane. Essentially, people wouldn't be able to be anywhere near Sobble. They give these Pokemon just such outlandish descriptions that it's like, some Pokemon are like, they're the embodiment of a dead child, and now they're a Pokemon, and they're stuck in a Pokemon body. This is a hiker who died in the middle of a winter storm, and now it's a Pokemon. I swear, some of these descriptions, they've just gone full bonkers. You know, I don't want to be playing as a Pokemon who's like a dead child. That's just kind of creepy, and more fitting of a horror movie. But anyway, this Sobble is essentially jumping at you to give you a hug, and we're going to, like I said, give it Squirtle's legs, and that this would be something that this Pokemon would use. It would use the power of its legs to jump up and start spinning at its opponents. We are going to give this Pokemon a shell like Squirtle, and that would be one of its main attacks, a spinning shell attack, if you will, and it would come at you with a lot of power. But as I was saying, guys, this will be the last video of the year, so we're ending 2019 with a Pokemon fusion. I just thought it would be nice, and coming with 2020, I really want to do more of this. If you are interested, you can and you like the finished version of these drawings, I'll always post them on Twitter, so you can follow me there. And if you want to take a better look at the drawings or even get a copy of the drawing, you can find it there. And yeah, in 2020 I really want to do more of these things. They're just entertaining. It's a nice challenge. It allows me to grow as an illustrator as well. And so I hope it's something that you enjoy as well, and keep giving me your suggestions, because they mean a lot to me. And it's nice sometimes to just pick something that someone chose and as an idea, instead of picking it myself or creating something myself. And this would be Sobtle or Squirtle. And again, look at this happy Pokemon. I want to give it a hug. So now it's up to you guys. You will be seeing after I do the coloring of this one. Let me just fix the name, because that's not right. That's not right at all. There we go, Squirtle. Here's the finished version, very happy Pokemon. And now you should be seeing on your screen all three starters. So now I ask of you, which starter would you pick of these three fusions? Which one would you pick to play as? But that's going to be it for this video, my friends. And this, like I said, will be the last video of the year. 2019 for my channel, it's been a year of up and downs, as they tend to be. The start of the year started out strong, but these last 2 months on YouTube, you know, they've had a fair amount of challenges, and I feel that there will continue to be a lot of challenges starting in 2020. Who knows what's going to happen, but YouTube has become a big part of my life, as you know, and I want to keep doing these projects, and I certainly hope that I can do more illustrations and maybe try even some new things, because it's always fun to expand the content of your channel and create new, brand new content for people to enjoy, even if it sometimes it feels like it's something that comes out of nowhere. I'm always looking for ways to expand my channel. So thank you so much for watching, thank you so much for supporting the channel, and I hope that you have wonderful holidays, have a happy new year. I'm wishing you lots of luck, and I will see you next year with brand new videos. Take care, everybody. Thanks for watching.